I went to England. Later on, I enrolled at the London Polytechnic with the idea of studying architect. Architecture fascinated me. I wanted to do this. I wanted to change various concepts that I had in my head. But then living in England provided me wonderful access to so many museums. And also, so much proximity, which I used to visit Paris and other European cities. And this is where my leaning toward the art became much stronger. And I could now use whatever talent I had as a child to actually put on paper images that were occupying my head all the time. And then when I found out that I could do this by drawing, by making work, created a certain sense of privacy and isolation because I wanted to do this on my own. Anyway, having spent this period in England, which was until about 5 years, I traveled a little bit in Europe and then went back to Lebanon. And then decided to come to Italy. The relationship with the United States and my family is very strong because my father and both my father and grandfather were early immigrants to the United States. My grandfather lived in Virginia and died in Virginia, whereas my father went to Mexico, where he established a business. He became very successful. And my father literally turned his success to dedication to the poor. He was in Mexico during the revolutionary period in the 20s and 30s and turned all his attention toward helping. And so for me, he was my hero and my inspiration. When I came to New York, I went to New York University. I still continued my study in philosophy and political science and art history. And then I went to Art Student League and other art schools. But I was too impatient to sit through a long program. And so I began to paint and teach myself really a lot. Early in the 70s, during that period, while studying at NYU, we had the war in Vietnam. The Vietnam War dominated the atmosphere in New York in a way that was absolutely incredible, very strong.